saved my soul.
The very moment he forgave me, he took away my heavy burdens. Lord, he gave me peace with him. Well, Satan can't make me doubt it.
I won't doubt it.
It's real and I'm gonna shout it. Well, I was there.
Hold on. I hate to interrupt, but you guys got something else. I'm sorry. I can't market gospel no more.
So that's it?
I don't record material that doesn't sell, Mr. Cash, and gospel like that doesn't sell.
So is it the gospel or the way I sing it?
Both.
Well, what's wrong with the way I sing it?
I don't believe you.
You saying I don't believe in God?
JR, come on, let's go.
No, I want to understand. I mean, we come down here, we play for a minute, and he tells me I don't believe in God.
You know exactly what I'm telling you. We've already heard that song 100 times, just like that, just like how you sang it.
Well, he didn't let us bring it home.
Bring it home? All right, let's bring it home. If he was hit by a truck and you were lying out in that gutter dying and you had time to sing one song, one song people would remember before your dirt. One song that would let God know what you felt about your time here on earth. One song that would sum you up. You telling me that's the song you'd sing? That same Jimmy Davis tune we hear on the radio all day about your peace within and how it's real and how you're gonna shout it? Or would you sing something different? Something real. Something you felt. Because I'm telling you right now, that's the kind of song people want to hear. That's the kind of song that truly saves people. It ain't got nothing to do with believing in God, Mr. Cash. It has to do with believing in yourself.